Hello there and welcome to the Observer Chat Show, MEPs Talk About EU. Joining me here today to discuss the European Citizen Initiative is Hungarian MEP Zita Gurmai from the Socialist Group and Mr. Tony Venables, Director of the European Citizen Action Service. Thanks, Miriam, for coming along today.
Pleasure.
Thank you very much for watching. So without further ado, let's talk about EU. So from April the 1st, EU citizens will be able to sign mass petitions asking the European Union to consider introducing new legislation in their area of choice. One of the brainchilds of the Lisbon Treaty, the idea is to bring about more democracy and give citizens more of a say in decision making. But there's still a lot of questions that need to be answered. Some feel that the new initiative is complicated, some feel that it's a little bit confusing, and some folk out there haven't even heard of it. Before we start, let's take a look at this little clip from people from Brussels talking about the ECI.
No, never heard of it.
No, I've never heard of it. No.
Donc je ne connaissais pas du tout l'initiative. Donc les gens peuvent écrire quelque chose, des idées, et c'est pris en compte par la Commission européenne. C'est ça en fait.
Actually, I haven't heard much about it myself, so I don't know what the people of Sweden will think about it or want to do with it. But
I think the people don't identify enough with the European Union, and they aren't ready for to be a citizen of the European Union, but I think for myself it's a good chance for the people, yes.
I would be glad if this citizenship would be realized, because I think more democracy would be good for every one of us here in Europe.
So let's start with you. You've been one of the main ladies here in the European Parliament who's been steering this initiative. So we know that you need 1 million signatures. We know that we also know that the representatives must come from 7 different countries. Tell us a bit more about this initiative. And in the end, what are the chances that the Commission will accept your idea?
Okay. So first of all, the job of the European parliamentarians, and it's really for all of us, I would say, the role was to prepare an instrument which is which gives a good guidance for the participatory democracy. And of course, our idea was just to generalize debate on European level. And I just would like to make a small correction, if you don't mind. These are not mass petition, because we really would like to make a proper definition and division between petition and European Citizens Initiative, because petition, which is a non-discrimination and citizenship part of the treaty of the functioning of the European Union, can be tabled by even one person, and normally it is addressed to the European Parliament's petition committee.
So hence we see the confusion already starting. Yeah, I was even confused.
No, but that's why I think it is an extremely good occasion, and I'm very pleased as mama of the ECI to be here. But petitions have a local and a regional dimension. What about the Spanish cause? That is, you know, a petition that my colleagues meet on a regular basis. ECI, the title 2 of the treaty on democracy, which really shows that we really would like to give a new instrument for the European citizens, the need 1 million signatures who are addressed to the European Commission, so that's not the Parliament, this is the Commission, and they have an important follow-up phase. And ECI have a European dimension, so I think it is very, very important. We are still fighting doing the follow-up in the Parliament, because we would like to have a public hearing as the 1 million signatures could be collected. And of course, it is very, very important to make a proper definition, because if we confuse, then what about ordinary citizens?
Absolutely.
So we have a responsibility.
Let's bring in Tony here. Tony, some critics are saying that it's just a gesture from the European Union to show that they're involving the citizens. Do you think so? And what do you think the EU should do to really spread the word about this and inform citizens in all the member states and not just people here in Brussels?
Dieter is right. It's more than a petition. It's an agenda-setting instrument. Provided it's sort of in the legal competence of the Commission and you get the 1 million signatures from a minimum 7 countries and you come forward with this, if it's in the legal area of the treaties, the Commission should take action, but it does not have to. It's not obliged to. So there is a certain ambiguity here. It's not direct democracy. It's more deliberative democracy. But we are relatively optimistic because, at the moment, in a Brussels surrounded by lobbies, very difficult climate out there.
You don't want the lobbyists to come and take over.
Why would the Commission refuse a really good initiative on water as a human right, media pluralism, minimum income. You know, there's some very good initiatives being prepared at the moment.
And you said that citizens cannot, that we cannot change the treaty, and a lot of citizens would like to see it, would like to sign a petition, for example, to have one seat for the European Parliament in Brussels, but this is impossible. So can you give us a few samples of what are possible? What are like successful ECI cases?
For example, this EPSO water issue, that I think
one.
That you are for proper energy, you are for proper water.
Yeah.
And I think I would say that we really have to respect the next generation. So how much we are taking care of the next generation, we overconsume. The reason of the crisis that we become so much more that we have. And don't forget that all the, sorry to say, the media gives a guidance, buy this, buy that. Meanwhile, you don't need it any longer. And as if we would listen to my grandmother's advice, that when you have 8 potato, use only 6 and take it for 2 for the winter time. But now the problem is that instead of 8 potatoes, just to be simple as possible, we eat 16. And look at the size of the Europeans. That is the impression that voto had it. So that's why I believe, and of course I agree with you, that was... Probably that was more than a gesture, because Europe is in a real moral crisis. The values are in moral crisis, and I believe that they understood that now we should have a type of personal touch with citizens. Yeah. And of course, 1 million is a lot of signatures, so let's be realistic. It is very, very difficult. I was collecting signatures. I'm a woman from the grassroots movement. When we had the World Cup in 2006 against the forced prostitution, because I believe it's a sexual slavery, and to collect 124,000 signatures, and we didn't ask any ID or data or online or not online, so we know how difficult it is. But what we really
Even
would like to...
It's easier because you have social media and we have the whole kind of sexism.
Yes.
It's very easy, you just click.
Sure.
Well, it's not going to be that simple,
because
you need to put your
first
details.
Of all, you have to think. The second, of course, we really wanted to generalize debate on European level, because the problem is that we are very local, we are very national, and let's be fair, how are our fantastic leaders on European level? Look at when they are here at the council meeting, they are lovely, beautiful Europeans, and when they go home, they just do local and national, and they have actually two hats, as my Prime Minister Orban said when we had the Hungarian presidency, we have only one hat, and we have a responsibility on that side, I would say, that you should take what you do.
Let's talk a little bit about the support for the ECI. From in the Parliament, within the Parliament, there's a huge majority support. There's just one group, ironically enough, called the Europe for Freedom and Democracy. So the ones who are always complaining that there's not enough democracy in the EU, they've called it a drip propaganda tool of the European Parliament that's going to cost about 100 million. How did you kind of fight against that sort of criticism?
Honestly, if the Parliament agreed with 98% to accept this work, it means, first of all, we were very good, which I think that there were no doubt. The second, this is a very tiny opposition, and I would respect their opinion, but then they should respect the opinion of the mass majority. So I don't think that we should listen to them, but of course we should keep our line. And then, of course, I'm always happy to hear them. And what is your proper suggestion? How can we do it better? They cannot give you a better guidance just to make nice blah, blah. I don't think it helps.
And what about the Commission? I mean, we haven't heard Barroso, we haven't heard any fancy speeches from him hailing this as a wonderful success.
I agree. I mean, we had a conference last week with about 200 participants, and people were a little bit concerned about the Commission. And Sefcovic, who's the Commissioner responsible, is doing a really good job. But we're not certain that there's the political backing there in the Commission, as it certainly is in the Parliament. And we had a really good working relationship with the Parliament, lots of hearings, etc. Commission, it's not so clear. And one thing which is coming out very strongly is that people don't know about it. I think your clip shows that. You know, they haven't heard about this, so it's going to be harder to collect the signatures, unfortunately. So the
and
Commission
funny, I was taking that video about 2 minutes away from here from the European Parliament in Rue Belliard, just under a beautiful poster.
Yeah.
Promoting
right.
the European Citizen Initiative. So if people here in Brussels don't know...
Yeah, but to answer your earlier question, the Commission is not launching a big communication campaign with the other institutions. And we did a survey of the member states, including Hungary, and the answer we got back was, okay, this is this is the authority, this is the law, which in many cases isn't yet completed. And by the way, no, we're not going to do... We're not planning any particular information or communication campaign. And it's very difficult for us to understand that, given the crisis Europe's in at the moment.
It cannot be an excuse, because no. I think that if there is a moral crisis, as I told you, in Europe, and there is a real gap between the European Union and ordinary citizens, then I think that we got a very clear signal from European citizens that we have to do something. And actually, I believe that it is a really great occasion to do something differently. So I strongly believe, and of course, I just fighted with Shefcovic just the day before, and I said that we have to put it on high level. I'm so proud of Martin Schulz, our new president of the parliament. He nominated a vice president, Mr. Papastamkos, who is ruling with the ECR, because he really wanted to show that this is an interest of the European Parliament, that just to show that we are them. And now we are still working, because I'm really doing the follow-up of the European Citizens Initiative as a rapporteur. I just got the fantastic new amendments, and of course I don't want to go into details yet. But of course, we would like to have the public hearing, and we would like the committee chairs to decide which is the committee who could deal with, because I am wondering if it's an eco-agriculture issue, then two committees, agriculture and the environmental committee, could deal with, or if it's a fishery issue, then let's see the fishery, but let's see the economic, let's see the environmental together again. So I believe that the petition committee has its proper job to deal with the petition, and all the other things are dealing with all the other, and then let's give a chance for us, for European parliamentarians, just to show that we are really serving the citizens. So that's a test for us, for European parliamentarians, how to fulfill the criteria from the point of view of ordinary citizens.
And we'll see when people go to vote in the next European elections whether their participation is increased or not. Time will tell. But anyway, we have
it's
to leave it there.
It's a pity, because you are right, 42% of the European citizens went on vote. Meanwhile, most of the cases, more than 80% happens in Europe. So that's time to do it.
Okay, from the European Parliament here in Brussels, thank you very much for watching. If you have a comment on the video, or if you'd like to send us an email, do email us at video@euobserver.com. Thank you very much for watching, and thank you, Tony and Zita, for coming in to talk to me.
Thank you so much. We would need-